Hello friends, for opening DMAT account, please make use of the link available in description. Totally we have prepared 10 videos in the fundamental analysis series. This is the 9th video. Watch all these 10 videos one by one so that you can easily understand the concept. Definitely these 10 videos will help you for doing fundamental analysis. Remaining videos link are in description. In quantitative analysis, finally we are going to see about economy analysis. One country's economy will directly reflect on that country's share market. For this, practically I can tell one example. That is, in parliament, during the budget session, see the movement of the Indian share market. Indian share market by that time will fluctuate like anything. During the budget session, why the market is fluctuating means all the investors will watch the government policies, and based on that government policies, what are the industries will get benefit, like that the investors will analyze and investors will invest in that type of industries. During the budget session, government will give many announcement. Based on those announcement, market will also fluctuate. For doing the economy analysis, 5 parameters are very important. In that, first parameter is GDP, that is gross domestic product. First we should understand what is GDP, then only you can easily understand how the GDP will impact on the share market like that. GDP is nothing but total value of the final goods produced and services provided in a country, that is called GDP. For example, how Indian GDP will be calculated means, in India, how much total final product produced, that product's total value, plus in India, how much total services provided, that services total value. This both value will be considered for calculating the Indian GDP. What is the meaning for final goods produced means, what are the products produced in India? For example, automobiles, mobile, air conditioner, refrigerator, like this, what are the goods produced in India? All that will be considered for calculating GDP. If any product is imported from other country means, that will not be added in the Indian GDP. For example, in India, one car is produced means that car will be considered as final product. Inside that car, many parts will be available, like engine, carburetor, like this many parts will be available inside that car. But these parts will not be considered as final product, and these parts will not be considered for calculating GDP. Only the car will be considered as final product, and that car will be considered for calculating GDP. One more example let me take. One mobile is produced in India means, in that mobile, battery, screen, camera, like that many parts will be available inside that mobile. But that parts will not be considered as final product. Only that mobile will be considered as final product, and that mobile will be considered for calculating GDP. Next, in India, what are the services provided means, like haircut, medical checkup, hotel services, automobile repair work, software services, like that, what are the services provided in our country, all that services will be considered for calculating GDP. How the GDP is calculated means, in India, how much total final product produced, that product's total value, plus in India, how much services provided, that services total value, using these values only, GDP is calculated. In simple, I can tell that Indian GDP is nothing but income of India. Normally, in all the countries, every 3 months once GDP will be calculated and it will be published. Normally, one country's wealth will be decided based on that country's GDP. One country's GDP is increasing means that country's overall business production is increasing and that country's overall business earnings is increasing. That is the meaning. So, whenever GDP increases, that time investors will get confident on the companies and also investors will confidently invest in share market. So that share market will have growth. In simple, if Indian GDP increases means, then Indian share market will have positive impact. For getting economics related data, you can make use of this website, Trading Economics. After opening the Trading Economics website, at the top, select the link indicator and in that, select the country India. Like this, Indian economics related data will open. In that, click the link GDP annual growth rate. Like this, Indian GDP growth rate chart will open. If you see the chart, you can easily understand that is for last 2 years, Indian GDP is very low. Especially in this quarterly, GDP growth rate was in negative. This happened because during coronavirus situation, there is no production happened in industries. So, GDP growth rate was in negative now. If I like to do the correct economy analysis, then I want to compare the Indian GDP with other countries' GDP. If you like to compare Indian GDP with other countries' GDP, then you can make use of this link compare. By using this link, you can compare the Indian GDP with other countries' GDP, so that you can do the better analysis. For last 2 years, Indian GDP is very low. But this low GDP not affected the Indian share market. Because at present, Indian share market is having nice growth. Why this low GDP not affected the Indian share market means, at present, overall all the countries' GDP is very low. So that only low GDP not affected the Indian share market. Suppose Indian GDP is alone very low means, that will definitely affect the Indian share market. By this, what you can understand means, you should compare Indian GDP with other countries' GDP. Then only you can do the better economy analysis. Next parameter in economy analysis we are going to see CRR and SLR, that is cash reserve ratio and statutory liquidity ratio. First we will see what is the meaning for CRR. In India, all the banks are in the control of RBI. Normally customers will deposit the amount in their bank account, but that bank cannot use that full deposit amount because from that deposit amount some percentage of amount should be deposited with RBI. How much percentage of amount should be deposited with RBI? That is indicated by the term CRR, that is cash reserve ratio. Next we are going to see the meaning for the term SLR. From that deposit amount, another some percentage of amount should be kept separately in the bank itself as a reserves. How much percentage of amount should be kept separately in the bank itself? That is indicated by the term SLR, that is statutory liquidity ratio. That bank should not use that amount. In simple, CRR means in the deposit amount, how much percentage of amount should be deposited with the RBI? That is nothing but CRR. Next, SLR means in the deposit amount, how much percentage of amount should be kept separately by the bank itself. That is nothing but SLR. After deducting CRR and SLR, balance amount only bank can use for giving loans. At present, RBI had fixed CRR as 3% and SLR as 18%. Now, I will take a small example. I am having account in SBI. In my account, if I deposit 100 rupees means, then SBI should not use that 100 rupees fully for issuing loans. Because in that 100 rupees, CRR 3% means 3 rupees I will get. That 3 rupees SBI will deposit with RBI. Next, in that 100 rupees, SLR 18% means I will get 18 rupees. That 18 rupees SBI has to keep separately in SBI itself. So, remaining 79 rupees only SBI can use for giving loans. Whenever RBI increases or decreases the CRR and SLR, the announcement will be like this. That is, CRR was reduced by 100 basis point. Like this, the announcement will come. 100 basis point is nothing but 1%. Suppose earlier CRR is 3% means, then after the announcement, CRR will reduce to 2%. Suppose if RBI reduces the CRR by 25 basis point means, then CRR will reduce by 0.25%. Next, if RBI reduces the CRR and SLR means, what will be the impact on share market we will see now. Suppose CRR and SLR was reduced means, then bank will have more amount for giving loans. If bank is giving more loan means, then bank will get more interest income. So, because of this, banking sector shares will have nice growth. Suppose RBI increased CRR and SLR means, by that time, bank liquidity will reduce. That is, bank will have less amount for giving loans. If bank is giving less loan means, then bank will get less interest income. So, because of this, banking sector shares will drop. Next, If RBI reduces the CRR and SLR means, what will be the impact on other shares we will see now. Whenever RBI reduces the CRR and SLR, that time bank will have more liquidity. So that bank will issue more loans. People also easily will get loans. Because of that, people can buy many luxury items. So, whenever CRR and SLR was reduced, that time, there is a chance that share market will have good impact. Especially, cyclical industries will have nice growth. Next parameter we are going to discuss about repo rate. Usually, people will get loan from the bank. Like that, banks will get loan from RBI. In which interest rate bank is getting loan from RBI, that interest rate is nothing but repo rate. Suppose RBI increases the repo rate means, then what will be the impact we will see now. If RBI increases the repo rate means, then bank will get loan from RBI at high interest rate. So, bank also will give loan to the people at high interest rate. Because bank got the loan at high interest rate. So that bank can give the loan to the people at high interest rate only. In bank, if loan interest rate is increased means, then people will avoid taking loan. So that people's spending capacity will decrease. In simple, if I want to tell means, unnecessarily people will not take any loan. And people will not spend money on luxury items. So, cyclical industries will get bad impact. Next, what will be the impact on companies we will see now. Normally, some companies used to take loan for working capital. Working capital means, in any company, for day-to-day business operation, how much amount is needed. That is called as working capital. Like purchase of raw materials, labor cost, electricity bill, like this, all these will come under working capital. Working capital is nothing but operating expense. When the repo rate increases, by that time, bank will give loan for companies also at high interest rate only. So that normally one businessman will take 100 crore rupees loan for working capital means, now after the repo rate increases, businessman will not take 100 crore rupees loan. Instead, he will take loan of 75 crore rupees or 50 crore rupees like that. Because loan is more costlier now, so that businessman will reduce the working capital. If company's working capital reduces means, then company's production also will reduce. If company's production reduces, then Indian GDP also will reduce. If Indian GDP reduces means, finally, it will give negative impact on share market. By seeing this, you may think that why not the government reduces repo rate so that Indian GDP will increase like that, you may think. What will happen if the repo rate reduces, we will see now. Suppose Indian government suddenly reduced repo rate from 5% to 2% means people will get loan at very low interest rate and easily people will get loan so that people's spending capacity will increase. If the spending capacity of the people increases means, then people will spend more money and they will buy more products. Because of this, demand of the product will increase in the market. Because of the high demand, price of the products will increase. Finally, this will lead to inflation. Suppose the repo rate was increased means GDP will reduce. Suppose the repo rate was decreased means that will lead to inflation. So, always government will balance the repo rate between GDP and inflation. In economy analysis, next parameter is balance of trade. In simple way, if I want to explain the balance of trade means, the difference between the value of exports and imports. That is called as balance of trade. For example, in India, totally 1000 rupees worth of product is exported and 800 rupees worth of product is imported means this is called as surplus trade or positive balance of trade. If surplus trade happens means that will be good for Indian economy. Suppose, for example, in India, totally 800 rupees worth of product is exported and 1000 rupees worth of product is imported means this is called as deficit trade or negative balance of trade. If deficit trade happens means that is not good for Indian economy. In India, if export increases and by that surplus trade happened means, then only we can earn more and more foreign currency. This will have positive impact on share market. In Trading Economics website, we are able to collect this balance of trade data. Click this balance of trade link. Recently, due to coronavirus situation, our imports had reduced. So that only in this quarterly, balance of trade was in positive. Otherwise, normally in India, when compared to exports, imports is higher. So that only balance of trade was in negative. In India, mainly we are importing gold and petroleum products. Indian government is recently giving more importance for battery vehicle. Suppose a battery vehicle gets success in road means, then because of this, our petroleum products imports will reduce. So that there is a chance that our balance of trade may become surplus. If India is doing more and more exports than the imports means, then only India will be able to earn more and more foreign currency. If India is earning more and more foreign currency means, then only Indian rupee value will rise. In economy analysis, last parameter is Indian monsoon. If Indian monsoon is good, then it will have good impact on share market. Because India is basically agricultural country. So, agricultural based products only we are exporting more to the other countries. If Indian monsoon is good, then our exports will be more than the imports. Because of that, India will be able to earn more and more foreign currency. If monsoon is good, then income from the agriculture will rise. So, unemployment will reduce. Because of this, people's spending capacity will rise. That is, people will purchase many luxury items. So, finally, cyclical industries will have good impact. In our channel, we have prepared totally 8 videos in the concept of basics of stock market. Please watch all those videos for understanding the basic terms in share market. All the videos link are in description. In this video, if you have any doubt, please make a comment, I will reply.